that song is from the original Wizard of Oz. And when that movie came out, it was 1930, whenever. It was old. And I'm sure when they played it back on their 1930 whatever stereo systems, it sounded as good as it could. Now, these are from 2017. And I started with the Judy Garland Over the Rainbow because they have this magic ability to make everything you play on them sound like it was recorded in Judy Garland's time. So let's see. We'll try some Johnny Cash, Walk the Line.
Watch on this heart of mine.
Okay, nice.
I keep my eyes wide open all the time.
The sound demo for these, I haven't recorded it yet, and it will be in the description, and it will be horrendous. Let's find something with modern, good vocals. Amber Rubarth, we got Jim Brickman here. Jethro Tull is here. Jethro Tull? Now, I'm not using these properly. I don't have the sub hooked up, which is required. I'm sure it was sold as a set. They show that on the Kickstarter. This company, by the way, contacted me and said, hey, we want to send you a set to review. And I looked at it, and I saw those, and I'm like, oh, they got flat panel transducer speakers. So there's motion transducers on there that are actually shaking this piece of carbon fiber to make sound. And way down the post, way down, you didn't want to show it, but boom. Oh, by the way, that's how you got to use it. So I thought I'd give it a little test before the actual review. I would not use this sub that has the amplifier for the speakers built into it, and I'd wire it up directly to my Emotiva A100 to really see what a flatline, no fuckery DSP correction can do for this monstrosity nightmare. I mean, I still want to do one. Boom. Oh, God. Jerry Clark Jr., boom. Okay. Let's hook them up the way they're supposed to be hooked up. Let's shut that off, or at least lower it. Let's look at what the kit comes with. What the 2.1 system comes with. Zeos, you never give a bad review. You just give everything's great to you. And I always try to see the positive sides to any product I review. I really do. I sit down and I'll like, oh, these suck 93% of the way, but the other 7%, this 7%, I can't kill everybody. There hasn't been a product lately that I've actually wanted to take in the back and shoot and put down like Old Yeller. These are close. So it comes with two panel speakers, which, by the way, these metal, they look great. I mean, that is carbon fiber. It's rather thick. It's got to be 3 mil. For you Americans, a little more than a 16th of an inch. This looks like stainless, bent. Oh, it's got holes of transducers in there. You could just see them under there. And the wire is attached, and it's, for whatever reason, the red and black. I mean, I know it's a Kickstarter, and this is like their first attempt. And I would usually give the benefit of a doubt, but either make the wire detachable or make the entire wire black and then just tape up the end, because that looks... I didn't tell you the price. You know, I'm not telling you the price. To benefit the company that sends this to me, in some small way, you'll have to click and look at their campaign. And then you could decide for yourself if you think it's worth the investment. But anyway, yeah. So you get two of these flat panels. This one, the only difference between the two is one of them actually has the brand name Vetter on it. They're weighty, and they look pretty, and they are really, I was hoping beyond hope when I said yes to a review that they would be just acceptable. And they're not even close. I mean, not even, not by a long shot. Honestly, it comes with those, the sub, the one of the worst 3.5 millimeter to RCAs, RCA to 3.5 that I've ever, like ever. I mean, the wire, it feels like one of the worst like wires. It's like a hard plastic that doesn't feel pleasing. And then these like metal ends, I don't know how they could, I don't know how. These are the, this is the worst quality one. It's like tin foil wrapped and it doesn't weigh anything. And it might work perfectly. It might work perfectly. I wouldn't know. I mean, I did plug it in, but no. Comes with a adapter, a 3.5 millimeter RCA. So essentially they give you, because the subwoofer takes two RCA sets in. You either get RCA in as television, RCA in as an auxiliary. It will accept Bluetooth, which you have to use a remote to program. And then you can plug this in here and it gives this, okay, K-wires. K-wires. Let's hook this up in the interim. Now that's the left speaker, so I've got to wire it to this side. Oh, when I took these apart, when I opened these up, the tinned ends of both speakers, because this is how you tin a wire, you put a little soldering iron, were so long that they wouldn't fully seat in the subwoofer. And I had to cut them with a wire cutters to make them the correct length, about half, so that when I go to install them, they don't stick up and potentially ground out. So that's just something you're gonna have to deal with. Well, no, no one's gonna have to deal with that. This is basically a, I'm sure the company's watching this, and I appreciate you guys trying something different, but you gotta really buy something, listen to it, and say, does ours sound even close to that? And if it doesn't, then what are you selling? You're selling hype for looks. So there we go, we've now installed that. We're gonna need a source. Zeos has sources everywhere. We'll even put it in the auxiliary. Okay, we need the power brick. Here's the power brick. What is this baby pulling? 18 volts at 3.5 amp. Okay, that's okay. It's okay. If you want to look at the sub for a second, which honestly, if this setup has any redeeming factor, it's that this little baby subwoofer is sort of kick-ass, and I kind of wish that someone would sell a sub like this. Because, I mean, it's got the heat panels in the back are crooked. They should be vertical because heat, the convex of air, it would be easier for it to travel up. If this was like this, like, then the heat, warm air will travel up and it'll pull it out. When you put it sideways, the heat sort of just sits there. So that's just a lesson for everybody who's designing things in the future. Power switch is here. It goes on. I think it goes on. Yeah, it's on. You know, I could tell because it's a fucking blue one. Okay. Anyway, let's pull this cover off. And we're looking at a foam surround 5.25 with a passive radiator on the bottom, a weighted passive radiator on the bottom. I like this design of a subwoofer. I mean, but the problem is that we're not buying a subwoofer. You're not buying a subwoofer. They tried to even hide the subwoofer. You're buying a 2.1, sort of. So let's put this in line. Everything in this place now, everything clean. I'll leave the cover off so we can watch the, watch the subwoofer do its magic. Now, the remote control. Pretty simple. Power, mute, volume down, volume up, treble down, treble up, bass down, bass up, auxiliary, Bluetooth, or TV. I'm not going to bother hooking up to Bluetooth on this. I would like to point out for a second, the instructions are amazing. I'm so into this font and color scheme, and it's like a blue that fades to a red. They went for that, like, I have an image, if I could find it. Like, they go for that, like, Miami Vice 80s. Like, this would have been the future in the past. You ever see those cars? Like, the flying cars of the 70s? What it would be like? That's what these feel like they're trying to be. And I love the font and the way it's spaced. This looks like I would have gotten it in the case for Vice City. For Grand Theft Auto Vice City. I mean, the little TV here is a Japanese... It's a Japanese TV because it's got the eyes... Because everything in Japan is basically an anime thing. Everything, everywhere. So recommended movie. Look, it's got recommended movies and music. That's cute. It's what you do on a Kickstarter. You're free to do anything because you're not a big company. You're not going to get lawyers to tell you you can't say this movie had racism in it. It doesn't matter. Because I love Kickstarters and I love Indiegogos and I love, you know, companies that are starting out. And this place is starting out. I just have a problem with everything. Sorry. Anyway, Heat, Bullet, Top Gun, Oblivion is amazing. Drive. It's not a redeeming... This is great. They tell you to rice up forever, rice up and whatever. Here, you could take a long look. But now that I've shown you this on this video, you no longer have to buy these speakers because now you know. Warranties and rules, contact info, how to hook it up. Enjoy your new speakers. My issue is I don't like being disappointed. When I get something like the M50Xs, which were touted as being fucking great, everyone loved them. My first review that I actually had to stop, back up from what everyone else was saying and say, what the fuck is wrong with everybody? What are you doing? And then people will still come, well, the M50Xs are still the flattest measuring. I don't fucking care. I have to wear them, listen to music. And you could say, thrilling, oh, hope you, paces, discover you like, I'll discover audio like you've never before. Well, let's see how that works out. Let's throw one of these on. Now it is on. Now that's off. Now it's on. Raising the volume now. Oh, I've got to hit TV. I've got to hit auxiliary.
Movies John Travolta made.
Guessing how much Elvis weighed. Those were the days.
A little bit of Simpsons. See, I'm a fun guy. I have a Simpsons soundtrack. Way too much Simpsons, by the way. Fucking way too much Simpsons. It comes up every time I play something. But let's put on something classic. Something that you all know. Even through my GoPro, through YouTube, you'll know how this song is supposed to sound. Play too much more of Mrs. Robinson. All right. This subwoofer, I don't know if they're DSPing it. Well, I know what they're doing with the subwoofer. I know they're DSPing the fuck out of it to try to take as much sound. Like, oh Jesus, these don't produce sound very well, but they look cool. Let's shove all the frequencies that this can't make into a mono subwoofer in the middle. Here, we'll disconnect one side. We'll disconnect the grounds from both. What are you stuck? I did a shitty job hooking this up. It's a mess. But here, now we're listening to just the subwoofer, right? Let's go back to Mrs. Robinson. If I can't sing and dance to Mrs. Robinson, something's wrong. You've erred in your ways. Sicario, no. I'm going to have to put it back. The subwoofer is attempting to fill in the blanks, but it's a subwoofer. And the problem is, you know how speakers work? Let's break this down. I'll break it down for them and for me. Speakers, and I'll use the Modhouse cubes here as an example of what a speaker is. A real speaker looks similar. This shakes and pushes the air. It makes a wave in the air, and the wave travels and you hear it, and that's sound. That's how sound works. Now, this particular speaker is a full range driver. That means that everything from high treble, like bells and guitar, happens. That means this has to move 20,000 times a second, and that's how treble comes out of it. And low end travels, you know, down, 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 slower, bigger waves, you know, 180, 50. That means this has to move 50 times a second. And there's only one of them. So this has to move all of those speeds. It has to be moving like this or 50 times a second, and at the same time moving like this to generate like 15,000 times a second or 10,000. And it does an amazing job. And the review of these is coming, and they will be given away. It's a giveaway, the first giveaway in a long time, because Modhouse Audio gave them to me and said, here, I have this and an extra amp. Promote the damn speakers. Tell me what you think. And these Vetters here, again, I'm not telling you the price, but it is several times more than these cost. And granted, you need to buy an amplifier for these, but holy shit, what real speakers can do. So like I was saying, this has to move very fast and very slow, and it makes bass and treble and mid-range and all the sounds you hear. Now, a speaker cone is light. It's a thin plastic with a magnet behind it that's moving it, so it can make it move as fast as it needs to. That's why when you get more powerful amplifiers, that doesn't always make it fucking louder. That could also just quickly move the thing where it needs to be. So the inherent issue, I'm going to crush sensitive stuff, with the Vetters here, is that they're not moving a thin membrane that, you know, especially, like, if it was just a 10-inch woofer, okay, maybe this weighs as much as a 10-inch woofer. But 10-inch woofers don't make treble. So this is responsible, this panel has to move back and forth to make treble. And it's so, even if it's carbon fiber, and it is legit carbon fiber, but even so, the magnet motors in the back of it cannot possibly move it fast enough to generate treble. This says has no treble. And I don't know where it cuts off. We could actually, do I have it on my desktop? This might be a good way to check this. Hold on, Windows key M. We're doing it live. Show desktop icons, here it goes. It's not there. Where is it? Where are you? I have a thing. I don't know what's in this folder. Is there nudity in this folder? I don't think there is. We're good. Emma Watson's up in this folder. Sign Gen. Boom! I got it. I'm going to close Foobar. And it's set to the origin. And we're going to throw a sine wave at this. Which a sine wave is literally the shape of the sound when I'm talking about it being 20 or 50 or whatever. Did it not close? It doesn't. I hate that. I hit the X and it doesn't close. Hit exit. So I'm going to turn this on. I think it's on. Power. We're muted here. This might blow up. Hold on a second. Oh, it's definitely trying. Oh, there you go. Okay, so now I have full control from 15 hertz, which is just trying to play right now, which is hysterical, all the way up to like 25,000. So we're going to figure out, and I'm going to reset the volume up. I tweaked the treble and bass. Actually, I'm going to give it all the treble it can go. All the treble. Fuck it, because there is none. Bass, I'm going to leave alone. And we're going to travel up slowly through the frequency response bands and see where this works. Now, I would do this for other speakers, but other speakers list what they can do, and they basically hit the full range of hearing, which is 20 is the lowest, and you really need a sub to get down that low. But 50 is 70, most speakers will come in. And then 20,000, I can't hear 20,000. I test myself with this program. Maybe I'll find a link to this program so you could all do this. But, you know, 20,000 is like when you're a young kid, you could definitely hear that. And then as you get older and older, it just starts fading away. And, you know, that's why it's hysterical when I go to audio shows and there's, you know, 55, 60-year-old audiophiles that are like, oh, I could definitely, yes, I could, yes. Meanwhile, I'm many years younger than them, and my friend who I brought was like 22, and we're looking at each other going, they can't hear what this is doing. I've sat in rooms with $30,000 speakers with blown tweeters. Blown. Either not making a sound or gargling, and I walk out of the room, and they're like, well, what'd you think? And I'm like, your tweeter's blown. you may want to go and listen to it. I don't know how I got off on that tangent. I don't even know where I am right now. Back to this. So, even with a dedicated subwoofer, I'll make sure the volume is up. That's maximum. She only starts buzzing at like 50 hertz. Which, okay, it's a little tiny subwoofer, but it's not a subwoofer. What this is a please try to make it sound like you should buy these box. 100 hertz. There's 100. So 50? I'd say this comes in at like 80 hertz or so, or you could actually say it's hitting a level spot. So now let's move on. Do I have the speakers hooked up? I don't have the speakers hooked up yet, right? No, they're still disconnected. Let's see where the subwoofer ends. I still hear that, right? That's 4,000 hertz. 4,000! Let me give you a little example. When you have a regular speaker, like those Swans over there, the cutoff between the mid-range and the tweeter will be somewhere around 2,000 hertz. And that's for a mid-range. That means that should be producing vocals. And then 2,000 hertz gets taken over, 2,500, 3,500. Depending on the design, it'll move to the tweeter. So this is a subwoofer that's at 4,000. Subwoofers shouldn't go above 80 to 100, which is where this starts. So 500 hertz, 1,000 hertz, 2,000 hertz. You can still, it's still trying to, it shouldn't be doing things at 2,000 hertz. The butter zone that it's trying to reproduce is between 80. Maybe 750 to 1,000. That's like where there's way too much signal coming out of that. So we're analyzing now. This is fun. This is like Zeus is being a detective. We're detecting how these speakers went absolutely fucking wrong. It's not hard. When I ordered them, when they asked me if I wanted to review them, and I said yes, I said, okay, transducers on surfaces can work. But, you know, you put it on a table and it's not going to sound great. You put it on a piece of painted glass, it's not going to sound great. Maybe if they're using carbon fiber, if it's thin enough, if it's light enough, if the transducers are pushed hard enough and fast enough, if they have enough power, if they DSP correct, maybe they can get a listenable. I just want it to be listenable. If these speakers, if I bought them from Best Buy on sale for $49.99, I'd return them. So now we've got these hooked up. Let's do the same test. We'll go from the bottom to the top. Okay, now we have sound at 5,000. Actually, I'm getting sound at 14,000. It's probably killing you all at home. Well, we're still in my range of hearing, but I'm not hearing anything. And then about 14,000 it comes in. So yes. So this test proves nothing, because these speakers are producing down up to 14,000 hertz. I'm impressed by that number. Back to shitting on them. Give me a second. Because I can't play Richard Cheese. Oh, I have the treble max, don't I? Yeah.
Log! Just tug its twig, and you'll turn your log into a talking tree, fluent in five foreign tongues!
Alright. These speakers hurt to listen to. They may touch 14,000 hertz. Fine. Hell, I can get my measurement microphone out and go at them, and it might even show a curve. But what it sounds like hurts. Like prisoners that committed mass murder, child rape, arson. That's one crime, by the way. It's a very special crime. should be forced to listen to their favorite music on these speakers. I need good. Stone Temple Pilots isn't the greatest fucking recording quality. Here you go. Some nice voice. No.
K-Billy Super Sounds of the 70s Weekend just keeps on coming with this little ditty that reached up to 21 in May of 1970. The George Baker Selection, Little Green Bag.
Just vocals. Just want vocals. I don't get them. Kickstand, no. Soul Coughing, they're good. Circles, I like it. Oh, another thing I figured out is that the bass and treble adjustments on this are way too violent. I mean, I know what they are. They want you to be able to try to fix this. But, I mean, I could take the treble, which is... I really should find music that's not going to get me monetarily blocked. But, what's next? Nightmare Before Christmas. The Neutron Dance by the Pointer Sisters. Oh, it's... Bass down. All right. Bass is basically gone. Oh, treble down. Treble down. It's still going. What the fuck? Oh, you hit volume. And it resets the treble. You can lower the bass and treble till it mutes. It's literally zero. It's producing none. So someone forgot to play with the DSP on the chip to make it not do that. So let's go up. Someone was not doing anything. Maximum treble. Oh, my fucking, I swear to Christ, it hurt. If it's not hurting your ears through YouTube, trust me, it's hurting my ears. So that's maximum treble. So that means literally this remote control is just controlling the level of these and the level of this. It's not even... Are they not even DSP correcting this? You have to DSP correct this. It's too weird a setup to not do that. All right. And there's no reset on this either. So it's like, I guess you're putting the treble back where it belongs. Bring up the bass all the way. All the way till that stops blinking. Okay, there we go. All the way down treble. All the way up bass. So literally bass and treble sliders are all this bass and all this treble. I don't understand the concept of this. I was actually working on a project 2 years ago. Designing a portable Bluetooth speaker, a Chromecast speaker, something like that. And we were a team. We were a designer, we had the manager, I had my friend who was going to do the electronics, and I was going to do the sound editing. And we're not going to get into specifics of it, but the research I put into that were frustrating. And it was enlightening because I knew what was possible. Like, wow, you can do all that with this chip and it puts out 30 watts a channel and we get the battery right and then we could mux in a treble and you could do all sorts of amazing things. And this is not using a single one of those things. And these cheap chips were cheap. So basically, you tell it how much subwoofer thingy you want and you tell it how much speaker you want. Right there. Right there. Wherever I've got it set, this balance. You could almost get away with these speakers. If no one's paying attention, if someone's, you know, they're over here and they're doing this and that's... You know, they're looking at their, you know, charts. Mmm, yes. These measurements are good. Mm. But then you hear it. Once you actually focus on it and you turn your head and you're like, I'm listening to music. Stop playing music. You're being bad. So yeah, no. Beautiful. They're beautiful. A good marketing effort. But no. 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 Fuck blue LEDs, first of all. Just fuck them to death. If I bring some attention to their campaign, maybe they can look at the problems, which are these aren't speakers, and then fix it. I understand where they're going for. You know what? No one has? No one has panel speakers. But I remember CompUSA back in like 2003. I was walking through there with my mom and I was like, oh, mommy, look, a CD writer. And I think I remember a pair of speakers that used this technology that were like this. And I'm pretty sure those sounded the same way. And then they were Cambridge Soundworks or something. So no. It's just a no. It's just a no. And I mean, they sound the same. Then when I hooked it up to the BassX, I thought this was going to be doing some crazy stuff to try to correct the failings of this. And it's not. So what we're left with is just failings. Endless failings. I guess I'm done here. I guess we're done. Almost work as a single. What this needs is a tweeter. I mean, this doesn't go low enough, and this could sort of rub mid-range around. If I kill the bass in this and I put that thing back on, I could figure out the frequency response to this, and then you need a tweeter. You can't make this a tweeter. It can't move. Even if it's producing 14,000 hertz, it's not doing it right. It's producing the entire thing, which tweeters are usually very small, fine things. You know, the biggest I've got is on my Airmotive 6s, and that's an Air Motion. But it's not mixing with the rest of the sound. This is bad. These are bad. I'll link this, and then I'm going to link those. And if you want something that's interesting and unique and you want to talk to your friends about it, you know, he cuts these in his own workshop, puts them together. They're $100. This is a new. Oh. I will play more in the sound demo. I will explain more in the sound demo. Wallpaper. Oh. At least you got a wallpaper out of this 23-minute long video. Download the wallpaper in the description, and I would say support me on Patreon, but frankly, I don't think any of you are going to after this. At least I didn't buy it with Patreon money. I'd feel bad. It was for free, and you guys, maybe I'll put up a poll on what I should do with these. How's that? Ooh, now it's getting interesting.